Good morning students. Welcome to biology online class from the Gopi Krishna High School. Today we will discuss about that light and photosynthesis. Yes, light also one form of the energy. Yesterday we have discussed about that different forms of the energy and composition of light. Light is also one form of the energy. Light rays are consist of tiny particles called photons. Yes, light rays are consist of tiny particles called photons. The energy carried by each photon is called a quantum. Yes, light is also one part in the electromagnetic radiation. Yes, what is the electromagnetic radiation? Last class also we have discussed about that. The radiation that is emitted by magnetic field whenever electricity is induced into the magnetic field. The radiation that is emitted by magnetic field, electromagnetic radiation. Yes, the radiation that is emitted by magnetic field when the electricity is induced into the magnetic field is called a electromagnetic radiation. This is the magnet. Yes, north, south. So the force of attraction of the magnet occurs a certain distance around the magnet. This is called as a magnetic field. If we are introducing the electricity into the magnetic field, some radiation is emitted. This is called as a electromagnetic radiation. Light also one part in the electromagnetic radiation. Other than light, several components are there in the electromagnetic radiation. They are cosmic rays, gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet radiation, infrared radiation, radio waves, microwaves. These are the components of electromagnetic radiation. So, for the photosynthesis, light also very important. At the time of John Ingenhouse, yes, they don't know what is the importance of photosynthesis, what is the role of light in the photosynthesis. Yes, John Ingenhouse, he conducted the experiment. He proved that light is essential for the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis also required the energy. The energy required for the photosynthesis will comes from the light, means sunlight. Yes, so energy is essential even for the process of photosynthesis. During the process of photosynthesis, light energy is utilized, that is converted as a chemical or bond energy, means glucose is formed. So when the energy is released, when the oxygen is added to the food, for example glucose C6H12O6, oxygen combines with the carbon of the food producing the carbon dioxide. Oxygen combines with the hydrogen of the food producing the water. During this process only energy is released. So in this way energy is released by the oxidation of the food, but how the if this process is reversed in the photosynthesis, during the photosynthesis carbon dioxide and water combines to forming the carbohydrate. During the photosynthesis, carbon dioxide combines with water to producing the carbohydrate C6H12O6 + 6H2O + 6O2. Yes. Lighter chlorophyll. So this photosynthesis, it is the reverse process to the respiration. This is the respiration. Yes. Photosynthesis is the reverse process to the respiration. During the respiration, oxygen is added to the food and producing the energy. During the photosynthesis, utilizing the light energy and producing the carbohydrate. So for the photosynthesis also, light is very essential. So John Ingenhouse. John Ingenhouse, yes, he was conducted the experiment in the year 1779, and he proved that light is essential for the photosynthesis. Light is essential for the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, light is essential for the photosynthesis. And he also found that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis only in the presence of sunlight. Yes. So John Ingenhouse, he conducted that one experiment, and he proved that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. Yes. Released in photosynthesis. Yes. So who proved that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis? John Ingenhouse in the year 1770 year. At the 20th century, at the beginning of 20th century, Engelmann, he also further confirmed that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. Engelmann also confirmed that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. John Ingenhouse discovered that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis only in the presence of light. And this Engelmann was further confirmed that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. And this Engelmann, he also conducted the experiment which light is more suitable for the photosynthesis. Yes, which light is more suitable for the photosynthesis? Now we will discuss this Engelmann experiment. This Engelmann, he took the one green algae and he exposed the all the seven colors of the light that present in the visible light. Look here, this is the algae stand. This one is the algae. Yes. And he exposed the light onto the prism. Then what will happen? This light is reflected. When light is incident on the prism, it is reflected into seven different colors like this. Seven different colors. Yes, what are the seven different colors in the visible light? Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. Yes. In this way, visible light is divided into seven different colors. When the light is induced onto the prism, it is deviated into or reflected into seven different colors. Yes. So what are the seven different colors? Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Then he also used the oxygen sensing bacteria First, he exposed the violet light onto the algae. Only few bacteria are accumulated. This one is the bacteria. Yes. Few bacteria are accumulated. Why? During the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is released. To this oxygen, bacteria are attracted. So only few bacteria attracted means the production of oxygen is very less. That's why few bacteria are gathered, attracted in this path of light. When he exposed the indigo light, here also only few bacteria are accumulated on the path of indigo light. Then he exposed the blue light, more bacteria are accumulated on the path of light. Yes. Next, he exposed the green light, no bacteria are accumulated, no bacteria are accumulated. Why? Green light is reflected by the chlorophyll pigment. Green light is reflected by the chlorophyll pigment. That means in the presence of green light, there is no photosynthesis. Next, he exposed the yellow light. Only few bacteria are accumulated or gathered in the path of light. Then orange light exposed onto the algae stand. Only few bacteria are accumulated. And finally, he exposed the red light. More bacteria are accumulated on the path of red light. So, by this experiment, this Engelmann found that two lights are more suitable for the photosynthesis. What are the two lights? Blue light, red light. Blue light and red lights are more suitable for the photosynthesis. In the presence of blue light and red light, rate of the photosynthesis will be maximum. Between these two lights also, between blue and red light also, in the presence of red light, the rate of photosynthesis is maximum. So by this we understood that the rate of photosynthesis is maximum in the presence of blue light and in the presence of red light. So blue light and red light are more suitable for the photosynthesis. Yes, which colors of light are more suitable for the photosynthesis? Blue light and red light. Look here, but in the presence of green light, the rate of photosynthesis is zero in the presence of green light. Why the rate of photosynthesis is zero in the presence of green light? Because chlorophyll is reflecting the green light, means green light is reflected by chlorophyll. That's why the rate of photosynthesis is zero in the presence of green light. So by this experiment, we understood that which lights are more suitable for the photosynthesis. The more suitable lights for the photosynthesis are blue light and red light. Now we will discuss what was the experiment of this John Ingenhouse. Yes, what he found that Ingenhouse found that, or he proved that, oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. Oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. In photosynthesis. Yes, during the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is released. Yes. Yes, how he proved that oxygen is released in the process of photosynthesis. For this, he took the few pieces of water plant like hydrilla. Yes, he took the few pieces of water plant like hydrilla. This is the hydrilla plant. Pieces of hydrilla. Yes. He took the, who? John Ingenhouse. He took the few pieces of water plant like hydrilla. Yes. It is a submerged water plant. It is living inside the water, not float over the surface of water. Living inside the water. Then he placed the
hydrilla pieces into the funnel. Yes. Then he introduced the hydrilla pieces into the funnel. Yes. Hydrilla pieces into the funnel. Then, yes, first he took the few pieces of water plant like hydrilla. These hydrilla pieces are placed into a funnel. Then the funnel is placed into a beaker of water. Funnel is placed into a beaker of water. Yes. Then he took the one thick walled test tube and filled with the water. Filled with the water. And removal of gaseous bubbles. Suppose if any gaseous bubbles are present in the test tube, shaking the test tube gently or slowly and removal of the gas bubbles. Then closing the mouth of the test tube with our thumb. Then the test tube is inverting over the narrow end of the funnel. Then removal of our thumb. Yes, we can take the one thick walled test tube filled with the water. Then carefully the test tube is inverted over the narrow end of the funnel by closing its mouth with the help of thumb. Yes. Next, when we remove off our thumb, what will happen? This entire test tube has the water. Yes. When we are inverted or removal of thumb, some water is fell down from the test tube to beaker. Still some water column is remains. This enter is the water. Yes. So why the some water is remains inside the test tube? All the fluids, they exert the lateral pressure, upward pressure, downward pressure. Here the water is exert the upward pressure. That's why still some water is remains inside the test tube. Then keep this entire apparatus in the sunlight for 2 to 3 hours. After some time, we will observe that small gas bubbles are comes out from the leaves of hydrilla pieces. These gas bubbles are collected at the end of the test tube. Yes. When sufficient gas is collected, this is the gas contain oxygen. Yes. Sufficient gas is collected into the test tube. Then the test tube is left from the funnel by closing its mouth with the help of thumb. Yes. Then the test tube is taking out from this beaker. Then this test tube has the gas. Then we will keep the burning splinter at the mouth of the test tube. Then what will happen? The splinter will glow brightly or brilliantly. Why? The gas present in the test tube that is escaping is oxygen. So this is the oxygen gas. That's why the burning splinter will glow brightly or brilliantly. By this we understood that the escaping gas is oxygen. So by this experiment we proved that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis. To release of oxygen, light also very essential. Suppose it will ask like this, how do you prove that oxygen is released during the photosynthesis only in the presence of light? For this also we will write the same answer. First take a few pieces of water plant like hydrilla. Then the hydrilla pieces are placed into the funnel. Then the funnel is inverted into the beaker of water. Then take the one test tube filled with the water and close its mouth with the help of thumb. Then the test tube is inverting over the narrow end of the funnel. Then removal of the thumb. Still some water column remains inside the test tube. Yes, we can make the one more like this setup only. One more like this setup. One setup is kept in the sunlight. Another setup apparatus is kept in the dark. Yes, after 2 to 3 hours, we will observe that release of gas bubbles from the leaves of hydrilla plant. Only the setup apparatus which is kept in the sunlight. You will not find or you will not observe release of gaseous bubbles from the pieces of hydrilla plant, the set of apparatus which is kept in the dark. So by this experiment we proved that oxygen is released during the process of photosynthesis only in the presence of light.